buddhiyukto jahati hai ubhe sukrta duskrute tasmad yogaya yujyasva yoga karmasu kaushalam. I got one more the definition. The earlier definition is yoga, samatvam yoga ucchate. The balance of mind is called yoga. Here, he rewrites. Yoga, karmasu kaushala. Kushalata, the skill. Skill in action is called yoga in this shloka. Buddhi yuktaha. Buddhi yuktaha, samatva buddhi yuktaha. The person who has got samatva buddhi. Jahati, he cast off, or he abandons. He just leaves. What? Buddhi yuktaha jahati. What jahati? What cast off? Ubhe. Both the things. Sukruta duskrute. Sukruta also he... Duskruta already given up. Sukruta also. Good thing, bad thing. Both we have to give up. Why? Bad thing, duskruta we have to give up. That is okay. Why? The sukruti. So duskruti will take us towards naraka. Sukruti will take us towards sarga. We need to have moksha. That's why sube sukruta duskrute jahati. We have to give up. Now see, by Bhagavan Ramakrishna Paramahansa says that to tie with iron, what is it? The chain, bondage. To tie with gold chain also bondage. You know? Gold also bondage only. Whether it is gold or iron, the bondage is bondage. Sukruta binds in this way, Duskruta binds in that way. That's all. Both are bondages. That's why he says, Sarvadharman Parityajya. He's going to say in the last chapter, Sarvadharman Parityajya Mamekam Sharanam Braja. Sukruta Duskruta Ube Jahati Iha Eholoke. Who's that? The person with balanced mind, Buddhi Yuktaha. Buddhi Yuktaha Iha Loke. Ube sukruta duskrute jahat. We have to give up this book. We should not have interest in this. Two things. That's why we are not doing good things also. Excuse me. We have to do good things. First we have to give up bad things. We have to do good things. When we do the good things without having the interest in that fruit, and we have to do this. This is how we have to understand. There are a lot of possibilities to get misunderstanding this text. Lot. We have to be very, very careful. Ube sukrata duskrute jahati. Tasmat. Therefore, yoga yujyasva. Just engage yourself in yoga. Again, engage yourself in yoga. What is yoga? Again, here one more spoon is given here. One more cup. Yoga karmasu kaushala. Yoga means karmasu kaushala. You do yoga. You do karma yoga. Karma yoga means, here yoga means, skill in action is called yoga. Yeah, 5 years back when I typewriting machine type, lot of mistakes, only mistakes. Few lines I will get. After 5 years I became master of the typing. Without looking, I will get it. I developed the skill. That means I became yogi. 1 month back, when I made upama, it became kali. Sometimes it goes into payasam also. More water payasam, less water kali. 1 month back. Now I become master. I know how to make upama. The easiest product when any guest comes to our house. Very easy. Master. Yoga karma kaushal. Skill in action. Oh, one boy said in school, hey, my mother is great. You give any topic without preparation, shit, talks, my mother, great. Your mother will talk only on the topics. My mother, without topic. Skill in action. Mukham karoti vachala. Skill in action. Any war, in the beginning only we feel very tough. The cycling also very tough. Then the cycle will go this side, all the sides will go. So left side, right side, the whole road is far as one. So after something, just give the, just leave the handlebar and do like this. Skill in action. That is not skill in action actually. That's not skill in action. So every action, activity when we do, by in time we will get massive over that particular activity. That is a skill. That is skill in the worldly element. Here skill means when you do any activity, that activity should not bind us. Bhagavan Adi Shankaracharya says that. Bandha Svabhavani Api. Even though the activities, the nature of bondage, it will create bondage, any activity. Bandha Svabhavani Api. Svabhavat Nivartante. Bandha Svabhavani Api Karmani. Svabhavat Nivartante. Tathi Kaushal. That is called Kushal. We will learn in 1 month also. In 1 year also. Some people, even 20 years. 20 years I am in this field. I do not get out of this expectation. People are there. 50 years I am in this field. I am not able to get out of this expectation. Then again, this is not the, we have not reached the kaushalata. Kaushalata. Even though we do the action should not bind us. This is called kaushalata. This is called yoga. Are you getting it? The skill in action, the outer world is different. The skill in action, the inner world is different. Any piece of work should not bind us without expectation. With all dedication when you do, that is called yoga karmasu kausha. Hey Arjuna, before Bhagavad Gita when you were fighting in the field, you expect success, name, fame. Now the same fight you are going to do without expecting that. Now you are going, because already Arjuna is very kushalta in archery. Number one, he is a skilled laborer. The skilled archer only. You get it?
Yes.
Skill in worldly level, skill in what's inner level. Yoga karma su kaushala. Whatever karma we do, the nature of karma is to bind us. But even though we do this karma, it's not binding us. Now we become kushala. Yoga karma su kaushala. We know how to do it. So jackfruit? Big jackfruit. Mm-hmm. So with all interest, we just take the jackfruit, take the knife. Narasimha. Everything, one piece. We'll take so many things are also coming with this one piece. He went already. Finished. There's a deep connection between our mouth and jackfruit. So many things. He tried to take from our mouth. Nothing is coming. Then we ask other people also come and help. They are also getting the problem. 4 or 5 people, one jackfruit finished. They are getting bound. So everyone is getting bondage out of this jackfruit. Kushalata means before getting into the jackfruit, just oil. Applied oil and chik. Yoga karma sa kaushala. The nature of jackfruit to bind. But you know, even though it is nature, the nature is to be bound. So we know how to deal it with appropriate instrument or equipment. This is called yoga karma sa kaushala. He says that you have to do karma. The nature of karma is it creates bondage. So you do in such a way that even though you do, it doesn't bind. You understood.
Yes.
Therefore, you have to go to next sloka. Karma, the next sloka is very nice sloka, bringing all together. Very nice sloka. Karma jam buddhi yuktahi. Phalam tektva manishinaha. Janma bandhavi nirmuktaha padam gachantya namayam karmaja manishiraha, the wise people, the great wise people. Here wise people, sadhaka, the wise people, manishinaha palam tektva, manishinaha buddhi yukta. They are having this kind of buddhi. Buddhi yoga means karma yoga, the balanced mind. Gurudev says here now, very buddhi yukta means very interesting commentary. the people who has got the buddhi, the intellect, under the control of intellect, they bring this mind. The mind is under the control of buddhi. It's called buddhiyukta. Very nicely he gives this interpretation. The balanced mind. If our mind goes out of our control, it's imbalanced. If it is under the control of intellect, it's balanced. Buddhiyukta. Under the control of intellect. Manishinaha buddhiyukta. Endowed with buddhi, the wisdom, the wise people. Manishinaha buddhiyukta. Phalam tektva. After abandoning the fruit. Which fruit? Jackfruit? Banana? Apple? No. Karmajam phalam. Karmajam. Jam means taking birth. The phalam is we are getting the phalam. Generally we are getting phalam from a fruit, tree. Here the tree is karma, is a tree. From that karma they get phalam. Karmajam phalam. The phalam is taking birth from karma. That means fruits of actions. Manishinaha buddhiyuktaha karmajam phalam tektva. Having given up this fruit, that's why we are offering the fruit at the feet of the Lord. Where you go to any temple, just at least two banana. Simply you will get very easily. Banana for all the fruits you are taking. Why you are offering fruit? Symbolic meaning of offering our karmajam phalam. Krishnarpanastu. Very nice culture we have. Karmajam phalam tektva. After that, janma bandha vinirmuktaha. Because we have given up the karma phala, there is no janma. Janma eva bandha, janma bandha. What is that? Freed from janma bandha. Janma bandha vinirmuktaha. When we have karma, suppose if we don't offer the karma, we have karma, karma phala, we die. This karma phala will follow us. Listen, I never do any bad things. Good things. No, okay, bad things now first. I never do any bad things to anyone. Why am I getting all those things? Only me. Why me? Why me? Because you did karma, you kept phala there. And you died, you came here, the karma phala is following you. I don't want this karma phala. No, you are the karta, you are the bhokta. I don't do any of the karma, bad karma to other people. Why I am suffering? Poor karma. Many people, I never did any good thing to anyone, but I don't know, I'm very happy in my life. From my childhood, I did only wrong thing. Look at my life, I'm very happy. Car, bungalow, name, everything. Good thing you have done, now you are here. Whatever bad thing you have done so far, it will follow you. Simple. Why action is anterior, reaction is posterior. It will come afterwards. The simple. When you understand this, the logic of karma, we never ask this kind of question. Why good people are suffering? Why bad people are what that? Happy. Yeah. This question will never get. Why? Future, present, simple. Otherwise, you will get completely convinced with that kind of people. If they say, I'm not going to temple, I'm not chanting Bhagavad Gita. I'm doing all kinds of things. But you see my life, how happy, complete. Yeah, you are good. Why? Yamimam Pushpitam Vachan, we should be a little careful. They speak flowery words and convince our mind also. Yes, I will follow you. Finished. You should be careful. Why? Karma is anterior. Reaction is positive. It will come in the future. That's why Swami Shivananda Maharaj said, do good, be good, do good, be good, do good, be good. Till we get this karma yoga. If you get this karma yoga concept, we are not interested in good also. Why? Good thing will create good karma, good fruit. We don't want fruit. Good fruit, you keep it. Thank you. Bad fruit, already I have given it. Desukura dushkute jahati. Janma bandha, because we have to exhaust our karma, that's why we have taken this birth. If there is no karma, there is no birth. Every karma will come in the form of a father first. Father's own karma. Yeah, own karma. Because you have to listen to your father. Go there. Okay. Come here. Okay. I like that. You will not get it. Mother, whatever she cooks, you have to eat. I don't like this. This is how I know that, sir. Whether you like it or not, this is a rasam. Many children will take this kind of food to the school, they share with other people. They share. We'll sit together, we'll share. Every day we'll bring whatever my father says, very nice, you share. Anyway, they have to exercise their karma. Father, share it. Hey, you have very large hearted. You share everything. Yes, I have very, very large heart. I share. This is because of our karma, we get father, mother. If suppose a person marries, finished, other type of karma starts now. Other karma starts. If it is positive karma, everything will be nice. If negative karma, finished. Then children, karma. So the shape of karma comes in the form of children. Good name, fame they are bringing. Because good karma this person has done, first time student. Bad karma did. Zero, zero, everywhere zero. Everything is there. What are the boss? According to our karma, we get boss. The colleague also. So our friends, everything, the company, office, everything is written by karma. No one can change. Harinapi, Harenapi, Surairapi, Brahmanapi. Lalada Likita Reka, Parimartum na Shakyate. Nobody can change our word. Lalada Likita. Who has written? We only written this. Who made destiny? We made our own destiny. So Krishna says, okay, every Janma you that exhaust your karma, just give up this karma, karma pala. When you are not interested in karma pala, karma also will go away. You will not get this janma. There is no worth going to college, school or office. Finished. Why? You will reach that paramapa. Padam gacchanti anamayam. Anamayam padam gacchanti. Beyond all evils. You reach there. See how the interesting goal he has shown. Paramapurushartha. Dharma artha kama moksha. Moksha is a paramapurushartha. So we have to reach this moksha through dharma artha kama. This is how they made. The final goal is moksha. He is telling the technique. Manishinaha buddhi yuktaha karmajam phalam tyaktva janma bandha vedir muktaha anamadam anamayam padam gacchanti. They reach there. That's why I am showing you. They are not swargaparaha, kamatma. I am saying, just get out of this kama, just go out of surga, I will show you the pada. Which pada? Anamayam pada. Yad gatvana nivartande taddhama paramamma. The goal is very clear. Goal, very highest goal. Moksha. Okay. When will I reach this? You tell me, when will I reach this? When will I reach? When will I reach this highest? In the next two slokas, he explained the goal of the life.